wrong fucking stat. Since I'm just using sword. Since it's just nice and mobility type shit, since I don't really like using slow from levels unless if it's triggered behind some achievement or whatever. Cause I've just mainly on I've only just been putting it on earth and fire. But I find that whenever I put it on water, I'm gonna say though, it's okay, you don't really have to take that as much as you can. Just like the one thing I don't really like about this game is that you can genuinely be very fucking aggressive. Because it's like, since you obviously get like special moves, and I'm presuming that you can, like, surely there's got to be each, obviously when you get a different weapon, even if you get the same weapon, you'll have different skills on it, like the move skills. So like when you press RB and Y, it does the move. But obviously if you've got the same weapon, it'll probably have a different version of a move on that RB and Y, obviously. But it's like, the first one that you get, even with the first sword, as soon as you start, I personally think it's the best one that you fucking get. If you jump over a move, it doesn't hit you. You move like a swing straight. If you jump over a move, it's like, what's so good about the move? It's the fact that you're gonna slip in the sky. If you know which bad enemy's coming, you can just do that and immediately just do it, hit them, and then you automatically recover. So I've noticed with the move, since you've got to like pretty much commit to sort of swings, you can't really do anything drawing swings because you've got to fully commit to it. But I've noticed when you do that special, well, it's, I think it's even any. You seem to recover faster within the move, so it allows you to like duck the dash. And there's just been so many situations that I've been in fights, I've done that, and then just automatically recovered, and then just carried the move at the same time. So the only weapons that I'm using is curved swords, I think that's what it is, but I'm certain there's two versions of swords that do the same attack. It's three versions of swords. 1, 2, 3. Because it also works kind of like Neo as well. Since when you keep, obviously if you're moving and you press B to obviously deflect, you do like a little dash. And the way the game works with the whole deflecting while parrying, you don't have to wait for the hit to just deflect. You don't have to wait for the move to deflect. In mid dash. And it will gets it on the hit. Like on the one fucking frame per parry. Even to be fair, it's like even the way the game's been made, it's that it is kind of like it's like funny in a way. It's just a sort of game where you get on fire, save point, you gain all your shit back. So it's like on this game, if you see a checkpoint, if you're fighting something that's you have to basically fight something. And then the checkpoint's there, it makes you play more aggressive because the fact, oh, I've got four flasks. I can just be over aggressive and just heal. I've killed it. Oh, look, now I've got all my shit back. And that enemy that I've just killed, because enemies that are near a big flag, like a main point flag, when you kill them, they don't respawn. So it's like, you can just be in your mind, rack, and just be super, super, even way more aggressive. Because this enemy is not going to respawn. As soon as I shoot it, that's the next one. Personally, I am the type of person when I play Souls games, I don't really give a shit about spells. I just play the fucking game, I'm playing a hack and slash. Learning how the armor movement is, learn the enemy type shit, dodge and roll, fucking parry shit, whatever. But especially on this game, since you've got two bombs, since you've literally got to do R3 to do your special moves, and then when you unlock the spells, you've got to do down on the right trigger. And I think it was one, because it was still like, it's just like, really on the yeah, obviously each one, each of the elements is different, but it just felt like it was in the way.
Yeah.
Souls games, you can do a move or something that can, like, guard break or stun enemies on hit. It's like a win-win situation. Like, it's a very good move to have. And it's same again, you fit this first spirit that you get for when you do your activation thing, like when you do your special move thing. It pretty much stuns anything. As soon as you do it, it hits the enemy, it stuns them. And it's like it. Because you get it straight, as soon as you beat the first boss, get it. Well, you've already got it. The boss, you've got to keep attacking it, and you can build it up and then you can just kill it. Kind of works that way. It's the same boss. Fighting him, you beat him, he transforms, and then you've got to keep attacking him until you've got your bar up, and then use your special just to kill him. And shit, like I said, I've literally got like 4 or 5 more spirits, but it's like, what's the point of me changing if I've literally got a fucking move that allows me to, if I'm going, like, if the boss is nearly dead, I can just do that, and it just stuns them even more, and I do more damage. It's like a no-brainer. Just wait to just use it on the right time. Don't just use it just to use it. You just wait until you've got the best opportunity to use it. So if the boss is nearly stunned, you just do it. And it's like you're doing like nearly 60, like nearly 40 to 45% damage in one go. I also keep forgetting as well, since this is basically a Dynasty Warriors game, since it's all the characters and all the characters from Dynasty. Even the combat's kind of the same. So you can do fucking, it's always the same move though. So it's like you can combine it, so you can press X triangle or XY, XXY, or XXY, XXXXY. To do like a special move. Did you play
rare trinkets lie dormant in this area.
Thank you.
Now we have the key. Whatever shall spring forth, that will be something to behold.
Oh, thank you! I didn't think anyone would come for me. I got myself captured while going after a little friend of mine, you see. I'll be able to get back myself. Don't worry, there are more of the little fellows waiting for me back on Mount Tien. We'll see each other again there. I'll be able to get back myself. Don't worry, there are more of the... We'll see each other again there.
Thank you.
forsaken sight. The damage to these bodies tells they died in horrendous pain. Zhang Rang, you wretch. Just what have you done here?
Another thing, this just shows you just how much I've not been paying attention to this fucking game. You can fucking you can basically switch weapons mid attack, so it allows you, so you can do swing, and then because when you keep your finger on RB to do the skills for the weapon, it says B, so you can do like swing with one weapon, and then you can press B and change to the other one. Mastery skill, and that's what one of the mastery skills where you can switch weapons. Well, I shouldn't say it's good, I should say it's just fluent. As soon as the attack finishes, I can immediately go into it.
is like a maze down here.
Yeah.
Let us split into... You needn't worry.
Warriors among their ranks. Is to become my grave.
Shot me? No, surely this... What? Surely this can't be the end of the mission. Well, it seemed like it, because I'm missing fucking...
These corpses are fresh. Keep your eyes sharp. Yourself.
one is in the bag.
The way appears narrow. I can see the prison further in.
Thank you for saving my life. I am Jen of Zhongshan Commandery. It is devoted to my protection. Please forgive its impoliteness. Eunuch Zhang has been rounding up innocent people and stealing their life energy underground here. If this white snake had not guarded me, I too would be. May I ask who you are? Colonel Yuan? The one who is favored so by the stars? What fate that we should meet here?
Indeed. I am Yuan Shao. So, this is what the stars foretell then.
Shu, I shall leave the young lady in your hands. We can't take her with us.
Well. Don't let your guard down out there.
It's not the end of the mission. Two parts.
Let's move. There's an entrance to the manor just up this way. That's all the information I was able to extract from that spy, though. Are you ready? Ruins. I dread to think what lurks here. Stay alert. He appears to be drawing water from the dungeon. It is not clear what he's doing.
Thank you.
not intend to perish here.
Oh, it's because of my mic then, I didn't realise, because what I normally do, I line it up to my headset and then I bring it down, so then it's like, that's like the level that, that's the distance you need it. Seem to kill him in a corner and the fucking the body just like it's always landing the same in the corner. talking about from fucking Ant-Man. Yeah. Because he's a time traveler. And the dude that he plays as, he hasn't been in Marvel for fucking years. Like I said, he used to like be the bad guy for Marvel, like for the Avengers, you know, say. Fucking like in the 60s. 70s. Yeah. None. This dude has been around more than everyone that saw Thanos knew Thanos was. This dude, like I said, in the comics, he hasn't even been in cartoons. Like, let's talk about it. Because obviously they've just brought him back. So, like, this dude is, yeah, he can try to find him.
Fine equipment, suiting of a warrior of your caliber.
But this dude is not. He's not been around for me, like I said. His main enemy, his main arch enemy in the film is going against Ant-Man. Obviously, it doesn't mean that it's only because of Ant-Man. But you gotta realize, Ant-Man can't do as the thing is himself. It's the suit. What does Tony make? He makes like 4 or 5 suits of the same thing. Obviously, it's not necessarily Ant-Man. I build these suits again and then go into them. Because that's a load of shit anyway.
Such ferocity. They must have seasoned warriors among their ranks.
It's like they even with Deadpool, they even got that one as well. Well, they changed it up, so. Saying that his immortality is like actual like comic and cartoons and shit, it's actually fan art. This just shows you just how much of a difference it is between the movie fan art to the comic fan art. He fucking curses fucking Deadpool with immortality. Oh, Thanos on other film, he can't do shit like that. Elixir. Yeah, but he doesn't even do the stones. He just does it. He just gives Deadpool immortality. Captain Marvel's in the film, or she's then literally about, you just forget about her, then she appears right at the end of the film to fucking get Thanos, to get Glover Thanos and shit, but they should have still done the way the Hulk should have gone, Roared Berserker Hulk, to fight Thanos. Well, but pretty much if we went fucking wall to there, we'd fucking wall with everyone. It could be leading up to it though, since we've Shield. Good job, he didn't have Magneto. Oh, he's got an infinite glove, there you go. Oh, good job. because there's even one point in the comics. Because the main reason why Thanos gives, he basically curses Deadpool with immortality, is because Deadpool falls in love with death. Obviously, death in the Marvel Universe is a female. And he obviously falls in love with death. And obviously, Thanos is also in love with death. So that's the reason why he gives the curses Deadpool with immortality. And even, he's like, even one part of the comics, Deadpool literally tricks fucking Thanos and taking the glove off. So everyone likes it. That's the only thing he does. That's it. But then he's like, Hulk being like Banner could just automatically just tap into Hulk. When you're done with that, then you can watch Baki, because I know Baki's on. Realize where's Cow Cow? He's gone.
I have much to attend to. Who dares to disturb me?
Greetings. It was Eunuch Jiang who spread the dubious elixir across the land, was it not? It seems you cannot talk your way out of conviction this time. So you have already thrown away your humanity.
Have you no respect for your superiors, Cao Cao? To sneak into my manor and disturb my work. In return for your discourtesy, I shall just have to make do with your tea.
I was pretty much doing the right thing at the beginning. You kill his men, well, you kill his spirits, and then it debuffs him.
Your discourtesy requires punishment.
Yeah.
You are... What is the meaning of... Wait! Just wait! What is it you desire? Riches? Treasure? Women? Oh! I know. The elixir, yes? I'll give you half of all of it!
With all this, I can finally forge an empire to last 1,000 years.
Looks like someone got here before us.
Yes. I remember.
This will bring forth a new wave of chaos on the land. If this is what has been destined, so be it. I shall just have to fight tooth and nail until the flames of chaos are quelled. I shall not allow my status as a mere advisor to hold me back any longer. The House of Han is on its knees. It no longer has the power to unite the nation. That is why... I, Xiao Xiao, shall bring down the evils of old and bring peace and prosperity to the land. What is needed now is a tactical mind unimpeded by morality. If you wish for an ally to walk beside you through the ravages of war, simply call upon this unscrupulous hero. For like Ju Chue, we shall soar through the sky engulfed in righteous fire.
Good old Xiao Dun.
War is upon us. I must leave the capital and begin preparations.
Meng Du, we are always at your service.
Looks like it's finally time for our men to get to work.
The secret of the elixir's whereabouts was taken by Zhang Rong with him to his grave. Elsewhere, Dong Zhuo, a man whose ambition outweighs his conscience, brought the capital to its knees by force. Both Yuan Shao and Cao Cao suspected him to be connected to the elixir and forged a plan to bring him down. These two great eminences lit the way and drew many together. They amassed a colossal force comprised of 18 separate armies to stand against Dong Zhuo.
Thanks. What's your name, warrior?
I follow General Gongsun. My name is Zhao Yun.
Benchu, victory is within our grasp.
Men, the time has come to make Dong Zhuo pay for his tyranny! All units attack!
I remember your face.
May glory find you once more on the battlefield today.
Our foes are strong as well. You said your name was Hong Jin? Can I ask you to attend to the wounded?
You propose I flee? To Meiwu Fort with the elixir?
Milord, I, Lu Bu, will hold the enemy back and buy you the time you need.
You do that, Lu Bu.
He's got the wrong voice, though. I'm sorry.